Welcome back to Cam and Company here on NRANews.com and Sirius XM Patriot 125 coming to you from the beautiful city of St. Louis, Missouri, where tomorrow the NRA annual meetings get underway in earnest. I got to tell you, I mean, this afternoon the doors were closed. They're still working on the exhibit hall, and there were easily over 1,000 people in the lobby of the convention center, the America Center, getting their registration, getting their badges, going to the NRA store. I mean, it was a busy Thursday, probably the busiest Thursday that I've seen at an annual meeting in 8 years, so I can only imagine what tomorrow is going to be like. Want to welcome to the program right now, Destiny from Fate of Destiny, the blog and the very popular YouTube channel. How are you doing, Destiny?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
You bet. Thanks for coming on the program. So are you based? Where are you based out of?
I'm actually from Wisconsin, so
really?
It was a little bit of a jog getting down here.
Yeah? Is this your first NRA annual meeting?
It is.
What are you looking forward to seeing the most?
Oh, man. You know, I went to SHOT Show in January, and I was definitely excited to see all the new guns and gear. That's what I get. Well, that's what I'm interested in.
Right.
But the people, meeting the others who share my interests in, you know, firearms and the shooting sport is just as rewarding, if not more so.
Now, I know that there are gun control advocates who are watching right now horrified at the prospect of a smart, intelligent, well-spoken young woman who is praising the shooting sports and guns and gear. You're their worst nightmare. Mayor Bloomberg has horrible dreams about you, Destiny. And that makes me smile. And I don't know if that makes me a bad person or not. How did you get into shooting?
Well, my family is military. Like, my parents were in the military, and my brother actually is serving right now. So guns have kind of always been around. And when I turned 21, I realized, wow, I can go buy my own handgun. And I started shooting regularly and realized, wow, I actually just really enjoy this. And it's something that I do with my whole family.
Really?
Yeah, even my little sister shoots. She's 14, and on a 22, she'll shoot me any day.
Really?
Yeah. I handle myself on the 1911.
Okay, all right. But you know, she's coming along, right?
Oh, she does great. I'm really proud of her.
Now, what about your friends? Do you have friends that say, Destiny, you're crazy? Or do you have friends that say, Destiny, take me shooting? Or do you have both?
A little bit of both. A lot of my guy friends are like, oh, man, that's cool. You like guns. But then they never, like, some of them will come out and shoot with me, and they find it's completely a different experience from what they're expecting. A lot of them just love it if they actually will get out and come out with me.
Right.
The girls are a little more tentative, but I have just one or two of my close friends who, anytime I take them out, they just have a party, and it's awesome to be able to share something that I love and to have them safely enjoy the shooting sports the way I do.
So how did you get involved with what made you decide to start blogging, and what made you decide to start putting up videos on YouTube?
Well, the funny thing is I started up my YouTube channel, and even my blog is just kind of, I have friends on the East Coast, and we're like, well, I want to be able to keep in touch. So when you do something fun, put a YouTube video up. And I started going to the range more and throwing up little videos with my cell phone of me shooting at the range. And they ended up catching attention from other people who I had, you know, never even met before. And it just kind of blossomed from there, because there's this whole community out there, you know, online as well as, you know, here at the NRA, that's just so encouraging, and they've been part of this journey with me experiencing firearms and, you know, getting into shooting.
Well, you've got some you've got some videos that have tens of thousands. What's the most popular video, do you know?
I have a couple of popular videos. I have one that, I just recently started writing for thetruthaboutguns.com and for softrep.com. And one of the videos that I reviewed, or it's a review video, I compare the Glock 26 to the Ruger LC9 and the Beretta Nano, because Beretta had sent me their Nano for T&E. And that one gets a lot of views because it's just kind of an across-the-board comparison of the three for concealed pistols or concealed carry pistol options.
So your audience is looking for they're looking for information about the guns that you're reviewing, right? Or are you showing them tips? Are you showing them how to be a better shooter?
Well, one of the things that, because I'm not an expert with this big, extensive background, I like to have this approach of, well, I'm just me and giving you my opinion and sharing my experience, but it also makes me very approachable for other new shooters or for females who are just getting into shooting. And that's something that I really get excited about, is, you know, supporting my Second Amendment rights through just the exposure and trying to be like a positive reflection on the community.
Right. Does it bother you that, you know, folks who are, let's say, not so supportive of the right to keep and bear arms would give you a hard time? Why would a nice young lady like you, Destiny, want to hold a gun and go to the range? Couldn't you just do something, I don't know, more ladylike?
I do get some comments. You know what's funny is even within the community, there are a couple of some individuals who aren't as welcoming to the idea of females and firearms. Like, they don't know how they feel about it.
Really?
Like, oh, man. Well, they like to regulate it, too. Like, well, maybe you should stick to those 22 calibers, or maybe you should just shoot the 38 specials, which I was surprised. But, you know, that's really the minority of the community.
Right.
Because there are so many more people who are like, well, yeah, let me teach you things, or, well, that's cool. Can you talk about such and such gun, or what's your opinion? But I really like sharing with other females, like, our experiences with. I just started getting into learning about concealed carrying because Wisconsin just passed their concealed carry recently. Yeah, waited a long time for that one.
I know. I mean, we were covering that, back when the NRA annual meeting was in Milwaukee in 2005, I think it was. That was an issue back then, and It took a long time, but we finally got it done, and Governor Scott Walker's actually here in town. You've got another Wisconsinite at the NRA annual meeting. He's going to be speaking tomorrow at the Celebration of American Values Leadership Forum.
Yeah, I'm hoping to go and catch that.
Yeah?
I'd really like to see him speak.
How has the passage of right to carry changed the debate at all in Wisconsin? I mean, here it's been several months now, and, I mean, the demand is through the roof. I understand, like, in the first couple of months, 70,000 or 80,000 applications. They were expecting about 100,000 in the first year. So clearly it's going to be more than that. Is there a pent-up demand for people wanting to be able to exercise their right of self-defense?
Just from what I see in my experience at the range, I'm seeing more and more people are coming to shoot. Mm-hmm. And also the pistols that are fit that concealed carry niche better than others, they're just flying off the shelves. So I'm not directly involved in that, but
right.
I can see, like, even more new shooters or more women shooters, or even just shooting some of the smaller, like the 380 or the 9mm that are a little easier to hide. I'm seeing more people taking them out to the range and giving them a rundown, and I know it's exciting to me. I really like seeing that growth.
Oh, absolutely. I think with folks who are going to the range, it's one thing to get your concealed carry license, but to actually take the time and practice, that's a big step. And not everybody does it, but I think everybody should. I'm guilty of it myself. I don't get out to the range as often as I should. Hopefully that will change. How often do you get to go?
Oh, as often as I can. I try to go about twice a week, but sometimes I am a broke college kid, so sometimes I can't always afford that. But
I understand. So let me ask you about a campus carry, if you don't mind. And I have no idea what your opinion is on this, but given that you are a college student, Wisconsin now has a right to carry. What do you think about the idea of extending that right onto college campuses?
I would really like to see it, because my campus, personally, where I go to school, they don't allow it. And I find it frustrating because some of my classes, either with night classes or with just, I have some art classes where I'll just be in the studio until, maybe 10 or 11 at night, and then I'm walking around, and I would just feel a little bit more comfortable if I could have that right that is granted to me outside of campus to be able to carry that.
You're the same person. In other words, you're the same person when you're off campus as you are when you're on.
Yeah. I mean, I would like to be able to have that same kind of peace of mind. Mm-hmm. I mean, obviously, I don't ever want to be in a situation where I have to use it. But it's always that I'd rather have it and not need it than
right.
need it and not have it.
Right. Well, and, I know that the people who run the universities around the country want to say, and they like to say, that violent crime is rare on their campuses. Certainly not non-existent. And we know that. I don't know if you know the story of Amanda Collins, the University of Nevada student who was a concealed carry holder. But her college, again, did not allow concealed carry, and she was sexually assaulted, and the guy went on to kidnap and ultimately murder a young woman there in the area. So, these things are real issues, I think, for college students. And the argument from the other side of, well, you're too immature, college students, they just drink way too much. They're just, you know, they're just all a bunch of druggies and alcoholics. We can't trust them with a firearm. That really rings hollow to me because I tell you, the more college students that I talk to about this issue, y'all seem fine to me. I mean, I don't know where these university presidents are coming from, what they're seeing, but I'm not seeing it.
Yeah, I think some of it is maybe more of a case of selective perception.
Right.
Where you don't, with the whole concealed carry issue to begin with, there are people who just don't want to see it. And so then the idea of someone who's maybe younger or just doesn't meet whatever their lofty standards are for who deserves to carry.
Right.
Aren't always congruent with the people who maybe need to carry or would just feel more safe, like me.
Right. Right. Well, I mean, I'm just looking here right now. There was 3 hours ago, police investigate armed robbery near Virginia Commonwealth University in Richmond. Los Angeles Times 8 hours ago, deadly shooting revives concerns about University of Southern California's neighborhood. Police report robbery near Radford University campus. A store near Texas Tech University robbed at gunpoint. You know, arrest made an armed robbery on the campus at Troy University in Alabama. It happens, and that's just in the past couple of days. So at some point, I think these officials need to dig their heads out of the sand. They're in the sand. That's where their heads are. And actually have a real – I would love to see a real conversation, not a recitation of talking points from a university official. I mean, but I'd love to see you sit down and talk with your university president about this and actually have a real back and forth on this issue, because you're right. I think there are a lot of individuals who just don't want to acknowledge the reality that college students are victims of crime. They're victims of violent crime. A campus does not automatically make you safe. And as you say, you know, you have a concealed carry license. The state of Wisconsin has said, Destiny, you can go wherever you're legally allowed to go. And why not college campuses? Why would we not extend that right to college campuses? I don't get it.
Yeah, I can't say that I really agree with that mindset.
So I'm curious, is this an issue? Have you ever talked to your fellow students about this issue? Do you talk Second Amendment issues?
A little bit. It's being in Wisconsin with the liberal centers of Milwaukee and Madison, there are a lot more people who are leaning more toward that anti-gun than
right.
the pro-gun. And so that's part of why I'm even on YouTube and doing my blog thing, because I have a harder time finding people who feel the same way. But even among my friends, like, they might not be excited about guns, but even having like a taser or like some kind of pocket knife or pepper spray, like with some of the regulations that limit that on campus, they might not I'm rambling. Some of my friends are more interested in some of the non-lethal options, and we don't even have that because campus carry is not allowed, you know, that certain.
So
like, a taser is not okay.
Really?
Yeah.
Pepper spray is not
like
okay?
No, actually, it's considered a weapon.
Really?
On my campus specifically. Yeah, it's not.
Wow.
Which I really don't agree with. I would really like to have at least something if I can't carry, you know, a pistol.
I am reminded, apparently, the Illinois State Police at one point handed out tongue depressors to women and said, if you are the victim of a sexual assault, make yourself vomit on your attacker. So perhaps that could be your weapon of choice.
I was given a whistle.
Really?
Yeah, so apparently, you know, criminals are going to stop once they hear loud noises, because that'll just solve it.
Wow. We're talking with Destiny from the Fate of Destiny blog and the YouTube channel. So are you going to be anywhere here at the annual meeting, or are you just going to be wandering around taking it all in?
Oh, I have for my website, for my YouTube channel, and for my blog, and also for SoftRep, I'm going to try and get quick little videos of a bunch of different booths here. So I'm really excited for having a really busy day tomorrow, and the whole weekend should be really, really packed.
Absolutely. All right, one final question for you before we let you get some sleep, because it is going to be a busy day tomorrow. You're in college now. Is this something, do you want to have a career in the shooting sports? Is this something that you want to pursue once you graduate?
Well, with college, my goal is I'd love to be a heart surgeon. That's where I'm aiming.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's the only thing that I get as excited about firearms is biology. That's pretty much those two interests right there. And I definitely see me continuing what I do right now with writing, with my videos, because I love it so much. I mean, that's why I post a video every week, because I really enjoy it. But the main end of the line goal is to do my medical career and I'm gonna stick with that, and we'll see where the gun thing takes me, just because I can't see it not being a part of my life because I enjoy it so much.
Right. I think that's cool. I think that's very, very cool. I wish you the very best of luck. I hope you can come on the show again, when we get back to D.C. I'd love to have you on again.
Well, that would be awesome. I would be honored.
All right. Now, what's the best way that folks can find you, either on YouTube or the blog? You said you're writing for truthaboutguns.com now.
Yes, I do. And probably the easiest way, I'm on Facebook and Twitter, so facebook.com/thefateofdestiny or twitter.com/fateofdestiny is a great way to get a hold of me. Actually, that's why I'm here, because I was pinged on Twitter so I could come and talk with you guys.
Yeah, about that? I love the social media.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Hey, Destiny, thank you so much for coming on the program, and I hope we can do it again soon.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Have fun in St. Louis.
Take care.